I arrived at Otis in 1986. My ceramic training lasted for 3 years until 1989. I decided I wanted to enroll in a ceramics class so that I could make coffee mugs for all of the faculty at Crossroads School. At the time, I was the academic dean of the middle school, and I wanted to make a coffee mug for everyone for Christmas. I enrolled in a throwing class at Otis College of Art and Design, and then eventually I would study with Ralph Bacerra, which is not what you really do when you study with Ralph Bacerra. You don't make coffee mugs. So I have yet to make the coffee mugs over 30 years later. I took the ceramics class, and one of the board of trustees noticed that I was there and knew me from Crossroads School. He was on the board of Crossroads School and at Otis, and so he introduced me to the president of the college, who took me out to lunch and said, would you come and please teach English at Otis? I knew I was leaving Crossroads School in order to enroll in ceramics, and I said, sure, I'll teach English over at Otis. In exchange, faculty are able to take classes. The interesting part was that my students in my evening classes when I was teaching English were actually my classmates during the day. You know, one of the things about Ralph is that he really believed in teaching technical skills, and he fundamentally believed this, even though conceptual art was the rage at the time. He strongly believed in teaching technical skills at all levels, so I had to learn low fire, medium temperature, and high fire ceramics. So hand building, throwing, plaster mold making, glaze chemistry at low fire, very low fire china paint. We learned raku. I mean, for me, everything is about painting. The glazes, I liked painting. I actually liked taking painting classes, but I didn't like the smell of the oil paint. Around 2011, we were able to restart the ceramic program, and I should mention that it's as a result of the support from the Boardman Family Foundation. When I first started teaching ceramics, I was teaching in the parking structure, and I took over two parking spaces, and I put cones around so that nobody would get nailed by any of the cars passing by. And then eventually, it was pretty clear that we needed a space, so they moved me into what is now called the Galef Art Center.